U ovom izdanju naše emisije vidjet ćete intervju koji smo snimili pre ove novonastale situacije. Dragi naši gledoci, ostanite kod kuće, ostanite na sigurnom i provedite prijatne trenutke uz program vaše omiljene DM Sat televizije. U ovom izdanju vidjet ćete intervju koji smo snimili sa sinom Charles Aznavour, Miša Aznavour. Naime, Miša je objavio film o svom ocu, legendarnom francuskom pevaču koji je ušao u istoriju kao najuspešniji i najpoznatiji francuski pevač i šansonjer sveta. Film se sastoji od videomaterijala koji je legendarni Charles Aznavour snimao tokom svojih svetskih turneja. Ova legenda francuskog šansona, kome su dodelili nadimak francuski Frank Sinatra, on ima i svoju zvezdu u Hollywoodu na Walk of Fame. Aznavour je prodao više od 100 miliona ploča u 80 zemalja širom sveta. Premijera njegovog filma organizovana je u operi Monte Carlo.
Hier encore, j'avais 20 ans, je caressais le temps et jouais de la vie comme on joue de l'amour et je vivais la nuit sans compter sur mes jours qui fuyaient dans le temps. J'ai fait tant de projets qui sont restés en l'air. J'ai fondé tant d'espoirs qui se sont envolés que je reste perdu, ne sachant où aller, les yeux cherchant le ciel.
Hello, my name is Miša Aznavour. Welcome to the premiere in Monaco of my movie, Le Regard de Charles. We're very excited to show the movie here, in that beautiful place that is Opéra Garnier. And we are looking forward to have a nice evening and to share a little bit of time with you.
This is Harlan's welcome to Monte Carlo for this screen of movie, Le Regard de Charles, on Opéra Garnier.
So here we are in the most beautiful place in the world, in Monte Carlo, and the reason is a fantastic one. We are going to see a premiere, a movie about a person who was and is still so important, left an amazing legacy. And good evening, nice to meet you here in Monte Carlo. How are you?
Thank you, good evening, nice to meet you too. Yes, I'm very excited to be in Monte Carlo. I don't come very often, but it's a beautiful place.
What could you tell our viewers? So what is expecting them, what is expecting you tonight here in Monte Carlo in the beautiful opera?
Well, tonight at the opera we will be showing the movie that I produced with my company. And it's the movie, in fact I took all the rushes from my dad from 1948 to 1982. Everything he shot in with his camera, and it's a movie a bit strange because it's a movie of Charles Aznavour, but he wasn't here until the end. He saw the rush with us, but he didn't see the montage. So it's a legacy of his vision of the world and the love he had for the people and the world and the curiosity he had for the world.
So thank you very much for this introduction. We are going to see the movie and we continue talking after the movie.
With pleasure, it will be a pleasure. Thank you.
Vous avez vu mon nom en lettres rouges sur le fronton de l'Olympia. Vous m'avez vu sur scène, de loin, de près, en images. Ces images qui bout à bout semblent dessiner ma vie. Vous m'avez vu, oui. Mais ce que vous ne savez pas, c'est que moi aussi je vous ai vu. En fait, je vous regarde depuis le début. C'est ma caméra qui m'a amené partout, au bout de la terre, au pays des merveilles. Toutes les bobines sont là. Je ne les ai encore montrées à personne. Je n'ai jamais revu ces images, mais je savais en les filmant qu'un jour vous les verriez. Certains filment pour se tenir à distance. Pour ma part, Je sens que je filme pour me rapprocher. Je suis un fils d'émigrants, comme tous ces gens qui cherchent une terre d'accueil. Nous sommes chacun le bout du monde. Nous sommes chacun une autre musique.
J'ai vécu le feu dans l'âme pour les filles au cœur chaud. J'ai vécu le désir planté dans la peau. J'ai vécu au nom des femmes pour l'amour et ses envies, croyant par moments toucher le paradis, en brûlant mes jours et consumant mes nuits.
Bonsoir, on est très heureux d'être ici à l'Opéra Garnier de Monte-Carlo pour présenter Le Regard de Charles. Je sais que ça va être une très belle soirée.
Hier encore, j'avais 20 ans, je caressais le temps.
What an amazing and what a successful evening yesterday. A beautiful presentation of the movie. I love the movie. It was very emotional. It really touched everybody in the audience. How do you feel today after seeing the reaction in Monte Carlo? How happy the people were to see the movie about your father, to see these really unique images about him, about his life, his work. I guess you feel very proud because everybody was so happy to see the movie.
It's true, it's very exciting to see all around the world, every places where we've seen where we screened the movie, how people react. And of course it's always, there's a lot in common, but with the mentality of people is different. And what is great in Monaco, it's a lot of different nationality. So you, in one place, you will have like all kind of people reacting away, and it was very exciting. Of course, what was the most exciting here in Monaco is the place where we screened the movie, because it has so much soul, it's so strong, it's like being in an opera, so it was very, very exciting.
Et jouer de la vie, comme on joue de l'amour, et je vivais la nuit.
Voir un film un peu étrange, c'est toutes les images que mon père a filmées de 1948 à 82, donc les années pellicules. C'est sa vision en fait du monde. Donc voilà, j'espère que vous passerez une bonne soirée.
Les yeux cherchant le ciel, mais le cœur mis en terre. Hier encore, j'avais 20 ans, je gaspillais le temps en croyant l'arrêter. Et pour le retenir, même le devancer, je n'ai fait que courir et me suis essoufflé. Ignorant le passé, conjuguant au futur, je précédais de moi toute conversation et donnais mon...
You have had a few really busy days. You have been showing the movie in Cannes, in Saint-Tropez. Maybe you can tell us something about those cities. And how do you personally like the movie? I have to be honest, I really, really loved it.
Thank you. So I really like this movie, you know, this movie. And my friends, Misha Aznavour, produced. So I think this project is massive. It's not like a small project. So thing is, I think this is the beginning, for the beginning. So we did Nice, Cannes, Saint-Tropez, and now we're in Monte Carlo. That was my plan, because I think it's the place to be. You know what I'm saying? From there, we can go around the world, because Monte Carlo is the big spot. This movie is a legend. So we started, so we're gonna make it around the world.
Carry me beyond all doubt and fears on passion's fantasy to God created spheres, desires, destiny made heavenly.
Hollywood, you may be homely in your...
Hello, Hollywood, and welcome to today's Walk of Fame ceremony. I'm Laurent Gubler, President and CEO of the Hollywood Chamber of Commerce, which is presenting today's program. Today, the 2,618th star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame will go to legendary performer Charles Aznavour.
I want to begin by thanking the Hollywood Chamber of Commerce, Laron. I want to thank you very much for inviting me to help celebrate the career and the contributions of a true international superstar. As a singer, as a songwriter, and as an actor, Charles Aznavour has entertained millions of fans worldwide for decades. His star on the Walk of Hall of Fame will shine just as bright as those as he has performed during his brilliant career with such stars such as Fred Astaire, Frank Sinatra, and Andrea Bocelli, just to name a few. But now today, in the United States of America, in the greatest state in the world, the state of California, right here in the epicenter of entertainment, the capital of entertainment, right here in Hollywood, in Los Angeles, California, his star today is on the Walk of Fame. Let's give it up for our great man. On behalf of the California State Senate and the incredible 40 million people of the great state of California, I'm deeply humbled and honored to honor this great man, this great legend. To each and every one of you, merci. Thank you very much, everybody. Thank you.
I've had the privilege of seeing Charles perform a number of times, and it's impossible to describe if you haven't seen it. He is a brilliant singer, of course, but he's also a brilliant actor of songs. And Sinatra once said, every song is a one-act play with one character. And Charles is an extraordinary actor as well as an extraordinary singer. I'm privileged to be here. He's a great humanitarian, a great singer, a great artist, written some of the best songs that have been written, period. And I'm really honored to be here to celebrate him. Congratulations, Charles.
In memory of our late honorary Johnny Grant, whose pin I wear, he administered the Walk of Fame for 30 years. I know he would have loved to have been here to honor you. In his memory, we hereby declare this Charles Aznavour Day in Hollywood.
Not only that you have been screening the movie in Monte Carlo, but also in the best place in Monte Carlo. Very important people from Monaco have been there. I was watching the reactions. They were congratulating you after the movie. It's so unique because it shows the life of your father from his own perspective. He loved to take the camera everywhere, to film everything. So maybe you can tell to our viewers from where came the idea to show his records, his movies that he was filming?
It came from just passion, in fact. I mean, I have a passion for my dad, but which is normal. But my associate, Mark Di Domenico, who was the director of the movie, was passionate about my dad too. So when he handed us the reels of these films, it was normal that we wanted to show it. And for him, for my dad, I think it's just that he had an immense curiosity of the world. So every expression, and he was an artist, of course, so every expression he could try to use to express his emotion and his curiosity would be good. That's why photography, he did a lot of photography. You can see a little bit in the movies because sometimes there's like still shots of photography. Those are all photographies he made. And the next step after photography is directing or using camera, and he was always with the camera. So, and of course he could have lost this, but he was very nitty about things. Everything was straight, well organized. My mom always used to say, it's great for a woman to find a man who's as nitty as itself. because both of them were like, everything had to be in the right place. And so it's a chance that he kept it in a good place and in good quality.
Thank you to all of you that you are here. I have to tell you something very important. I am in French and Armenian. To separate both is impossible. Like if you put the milk in the coffee, you can't separate them. I'm that. And it's fantastic to be able to have two different cultures working for you if you want to do something. And this is what I have done. After 2 days, after that start there, I can be somebody who can say that I'm also now a little bit Californian because I have my daughter here and my grandchildren. So the grandfather is American, and apart from that, I'm French and Armenian. Thank you for all of you, and goodbye.
Ladies and gentlemen, we proudly welcome to the Hollywood Walk of Fame, Charles Osnabor.
Happy. The word I can say is happy, and with a part of emotion, of course, because we are far away from my country, from my way of living, or my way of being received by the people. It's different here. America is always different. But I'm coming to America since 1949, and I learn slowly, little by little bit of English. It's not perfect. The perfection, even in Armenian, is not perfect for me. My perfection is French, because all my culture is French.
Sing along with me. What am I
quand je m'ennuie, je connais un coin dans Paris où l'on se rencontre entre amis pour faire une jam.
Chacun prend son instrument, qu'il soit tout court ou bien fort, laisse parler son tempérament pour faire une jam. Comme je ne suis pas musicien, mais que vraiment j'aime ça. Je l'ai mon frappant dans mes mains, chante pa la 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 la
pour vivre de ma vie l'essence qui m'oppresse. J'ai tout quitté sans chagrin ni regret, puisque les voyages forment la jeunesse. Aux gens curieux, j'ai répondu:
quoi? Qu'est-ce qu'ils ne sont entrevus?
J'ai pris le premier train qui partait le matin. Par hasard dans le train, il y avait une fille très bien. Comme le destin veille sur moi gentiment, elle était justement dans mon compartiment. Train roulant faisait un vacarme infernal. Sur la banquette en bois, on était plutôt mal. Et quand j'ai pris sa main parlant avec douceur, plus vite que le train allait mes battements de cœur. D'un ton charmant, un peu moqueur, en un instant j'ai pris son cœur. Lui proposait galamment
venez avec moi au wagon-restaurant. Sous le premier tunnel, très fort, je l'ai serré. Sous le second tunnel, un baiser violé. Puis nous sommes descendus dans une gare inconnue pour cacher notre amour dans un petit coin.
And also the words that were said during the movie, the explanation, was very touching, very emotional. Who was writing the text and how did you put the text together? Was it from the biographies or when you started to put the movie together, your father was still alive? He did not see the final montage, but did he tell you what he wants to be said in the movie, or from where came the text?
The texts are excerpts of the 5 books he've done and he published, and of course, too, we took a lot of the interviews he made for radios and for TV. And a question from me to you, because you don't speak French, so I guess that you read all the English, and so you thought that. You thought it was very touching. It was very nice for me to hear you say it's touching in English, because for me, I was reading the English subtitles and I was today maybe going to call my associate in Paris and tell him that maybe we should look through the English subtitles to see if there were as more emotion as the French. But I'm very happy to hear from you that for you, reading the English subtitles was touching, because in French, the words are very touching too.
It absolutely was, especially in the combination with the images that you see and with the music in the background. So you exactly could feel the atmosphere of that time that he had in this moment.
Oh, thank you very much. It's a pleasure to hear it.
Let me laugh and let me sing. Let me drown my sorrow. Help me stop remembering. Give me back tomorrow. Come and let the good wine pour. Liquor makes me blameless. Give me evermore and more. Get me drunk and painless. Ararech, eras, eis shoras. Shomanah, manah, manah, eich, eras, eis shoras. Eis shoras, manah, eras. Two guitars on his my head, with their playing persistence, all the feudal days ahead, all our vain existence. So what is life? Why live anyhow? Question your creator. We are alive a minute now, and dead a minute later. La, la, la. When you see my body drop, break beyond all waking, then your two guitars can start. Keep the music making. Let me hear your haunting theme, for my soul demands it. Until I'm too drunk to dream, play on I command it. We'll be right back.
your father was the greatest Franco-American artist. No doubts about that. He had so much success. He got so many awards. Do you know, when you were speaking to him, which award or which moment in his career, which success had in his heart a very special place? What was, from his point of view, his greatest success? And what is, from your point of view, the greatest success? Because there are so many, the program would be too short to mention everything.
Well, I guess that maybe the star on Hollywood Boulevard, I guess, and maybe the lifetime achievement in the Hall of Fame too, I think. But after that, I think that all of them were strong to him at the moment he received them. And I think it's all of them put together that helped him when he looked around, turned around and say, oh, I accomplished all this. But in the same time, he didn't really care for all the prizes.
To see the audience, the many people coming to his concerts, I think this is, for a singer, for an artist, always the best award.
Well, yes, for him, it was his drug. I mean, that's why I always say to the people who come to the screening, I said, thank you to them. For maybe they loved my dad, but they have to know that he loved them, but for sure as strong as they loved him. And it's now my time to thank all the audience and the people, because of them, he stayed longer alive, because he wanted every time to go and see them and express himself and sing and have the energy of their love. So it's an exchange. It wasn't only one way. It's not only the audience, not only my dad. What's beautiful, it's like a love story with the audience, and that's what kept him alive and like a drug addict.
Le principal, c'est que ça la danse pour faire une jam. Ha! Un jour de même, l'ennui me pesait pour vivre ma vie, l'essence qui m'oppresse. J'ai tout quitté sans chagrin ni l'autre, puisque les voyages forment la jeunesse. Aux gens curieux, j'ai répondu:
quoi?
J'ai pris le premier train qui partait le matin. Par hasard dans le train, il y avait une fille très bien. Comme le destin veille sur moi gentiment, elle était justement dans mon compartiment. Train roulant faisait un vacarme infernal. Sur la banquette en bois, on était plutôt mal. Et quand j'ai pris sa main par note avec douceur, plus vite que le train allait mes battements de cœur. D'un ton charmant, un peu moqueur, en un instant j'ai pris son cœur. Puis proposait galamment: venez avec moi au wagon-restaurant. Sous le premier tunnel très fort je l'ai serré. Sous le second tunnel un baiser puis volé. Puis nous sommes descendus dans une gare inconnue, pour cacher notre amour dans un petit coin perdu.
J'aime Paris au mois de mai.
Et moi aussi.
Avec ses bouquinistes et ses aquarellistes que le printemps a ramené, comme chaque année le long des quais.
The whole movie was really amazing. You told us also yesterday after the screening that altogether it took 2 years to put it together, because you had so much footage. Your father loved to film and he was filming so much. So in the end it took 2 years, and I think you made it perfectly, because from the beginning to the end it's really emotional. It's really interesting. We hear things from his point of view. We see some details of his life that he described in his own way, and I think it was really emotional from the beginning up to the end. Which part of the movie was your favorite?
Well, my favorite part, it's personal, but it's when I see my mom and my dad together, all in love, and for me it's a lot of emotion, and all the time I have to like keep a bit to me the tears, because it's magical to be able to be. It's like I was like a little mice, being able to see them like the first time they love each other and how strong it was. And no, this is like, even now I get a bit emotional. And this is my favorite part.
I totally agree with you. You could see the love in the eyes of your mother. It was really emotional. And I think this is the best thing and the best memories in life, just to record your everyday life. Because today it seems normal to you. But after 20, 30, 40 years, it's so unbelievable to see this emotion again.
Yes, and I think even more, like after 54 years, of course they loved each other, but there's life. There are some, like my grandparents, my mother's parents, they were holding hands after 50 years of life. They were still like walking and holding hands. But usually in a real couple, there was always affection, there's love, but it's not always like kissing and hugging. And of course, because it's other things that exchange in the couples, and it's beautiful to see it. It's beautiful to see it.
Thank you to all of you that you are here. I have to tell you something very important. I am in French and Armenian. To separate both is impossible. Like if you put the milk in the coffee, you can't separate them. I'm that. And it's fantastic to be able to have two different cultures working for you. If you want to do something, and this is what I have done. After 2 days, after that start there, I can be somebody who can say that I'm also now a little bit Californian, because I have my daughter here and my grandchildren. So the grandfather is American, and apart from that, I'm French and Armenian. Thank you for all of you, and goodbye.
Ladies and gentlemen, we proudly welcome to the Hollywood Walk of Fame, Charles Osnamore.
The songs of Aznavour, they are amazing. They will remain forever, definitely forever. You, as an artist yourself, how is it for you to listen to his songs? What is your favorite song? And which part of the movie did you like best? And do you maybe also want to mention something about your plans? Or we are going to show it, not to talk about the future plans.
So my favorite song of this artist, this legend, is Le Comédia.
Yeah.
I love this song. I really love this song. Which part of this movie, when it's mentioned, like, you know, this dad, you know, the love, you can see the real love. And also, I can see he started from nothing to something.
Yeah.
This is amazing. Yeah, this is amazing. You know, this is it's like American dream, you know, that people can believe that, oh, I can be you, that can be me tomorrow. If I watch it from this movie, people are going to be like, you know, motivation. And then, you know, I think you have different parts I love on this movie, you know. On my future plans, listen, I have try to, you know, keep in helping Misha for this movie, and then also like bring this movie, I don't know, around the world. And also I have my own project too, like artist. I'm gonna, you know, get ready for new single. So many things coming, yeah.
Everybody on the party, oh, with the sexy ladies, follow me on the dance floor. I'm your hero tonight. Voyais passer dans des bars chez mon dad qui te disait on dit quoi, on est là
Baby girl, laisse-moi te montrer jusqu'où je peux t'emmener. J'ai calé la gova, c'est le tempo. Fini les blèmes proches, te prends en heure. J'suis le héros que tu sais me vouloir.
You drive me crazy, top like superstar. When he move like this, your body crazy up. When he move like this, your body keep me up. When he move like this, your body bring it up. Everybody on the party, on the sexy ladies. Tonight. I don't have a time, let me make a money. You know what it is, let me make it. On dit quoi, on est là. Baby girl, laisse-moi te montrer juste où je peux t'emmener. I don't have a time, let me make a money. You know what it is, let me make a run, dit quoi, on est là. J'suis le héros de toutes tes meufs. You drive me crazy, top like superstar. When he move like this, your body crazy up. When he move like this, your body keep me up. When he move like this, your body bring it up. Everybody on the party, on the sexy ladies.
So I really have to thank you for this interview, and most of all I have to thank you for this movie. This is an amazing legacy, and as I mentioned already when we met each other, my husband and also my daughters, they are also me, a huge fan of your father. My husband is listening non-stop his music at home. Since we are married, like since 10 years, I know we are listening Aznavour at home on daily basis. And there are millions of fans of your late father all around the world. And for this reason, I really have to thank you for this movie, because this is something exceptional. This is something that will remain forever, like your father's song. And this is something that will show also to the future generations the life of your father. Thanks for this interview, and thank you for the movie.
Thank you very much for having me on the show, and I was very excited to have you and to meet you, and I hope it's a start of a new friendship, and we'll see soon for other projects.
With greatest pleasure. Also, thanks very much to you.
Thank you very much, DM Sat, for this interview. That was great, and then see you next.
Hier encore, j'avais 20 ans, je caressais le temps et jouais de la vie comme on joue de l'amour, et je vivais la nuit sans compter sur mes jours qui fuyaient dans le temps. J'ai fait tant de projets qui sont restés en l'air, j'ai fondé tant d'espoirs qui se sont envolés, que je reste perdu, ne sachant où aller, les yeux cherchant le ciel, mais le cœur.
Bonsoir. On est très heureux d'être ici à l'Opéra Garnier de Monte-Carlo pour présenter Le Regard de Charles. Je pense que ça va être une très belle soirée.
Hier encore, J'avais 20 ans, je caressais le temps et jouais de la vie comme on joue de l'amour, et je vivais la nuit.
Voir un film un peu étrange, c'est toutes les images que mon père a filmées de 1948 à 82, donc les années pellicules.
Les fonds des temps d'espoir,
et c'est sa vision en fait du monde.
Je reste tout perdu.
Donc voilà, j'espère que vous passez une bonne soirée.
Les yeux cherchant le ciel, mais le cœur mis en terre. Hier encore, j'avais 20 ans, je gaspillais le temps en croyant l'arrêter. Et pour le retenir, même le devancer, je n'ai fait que courir et me suis essoufflé. Ignorant le passé, conjuguant au futur, je précédais de moi toute conversation et donnais mon avis.
Hello, my name is Micha Aznavour. Welcome to the premiere in Monaco of my movie Le Regard de Charles. We're very excited to show the movie here in that beautiful place that is Opéra Garnier. And we are looking forward to have a nice evening and to share a little bit of time with you.
This is Harlens. Welcome to Monte Carlo for this screen of movie Le Regard de Charles on Opera Garnier.
U ovom izdanju naše emisije imali ste prilike da vidite intervju sa sinom Charles Aznavoura, Miša Aznavour. Naime, Miša, on je objavio film o svom ocu, legendarnom francuskom pevaču koji je ušao u istoriju kao najuspešniji i najpoznatiji francuski pevač i šansonjer sveta. Film se sastoji od videomaterijala koji je legendarni Charles Aznavour snimao tokom svojih svetskih turneja. Ova legenda francuskog šansona, kome su dodelili nadimak francuski Frank Sinatra, on ima i svoju zvezdu u Hollywoodu, na Walk of Fame. Aznavour je prodao više od 100 miliona ploča u 80 zemalja širom sveta. Premijera njegovog filma organizovana je u operi Monte Carlo. Tamo smo i snimili intervju sa njegovim sinom pre ove novonastale situacije. Dragi naši gledoci, ostanite i dalje uz program naše i vaše DMSA televizije i pre svega ostanite kod kuće, ostanite na sigurnom.
Likes to party, everybody wants to be someone. Nobody ever tried to rock it, to stop it, they were born. Girls want to find a real love, guys just want to get a bone. You just want to have my number, but I wanna take you home. Bachata, bachata, everybody wants to do. Bachata, it's hot cause you play. Bachata, spank me, baby.
Cavalli for everybody. I love you.
Victoria Phillips said, and you are watching DIMSAT program.
Hello, from Valentino.
Hi, Mary J. Blige.
Hi, this is Jermaine Jackson, and you're watching DIMSAT.
Yes, good evening. I am Placido Domingo, and you're watching DIMSAT.
Everybody wants to do the bachata. Everybody wants to get on down. Nobody wants to pay my duty. Nobody wants to hit the can.
Oh, no. I'm Vitaly Klitschko, you're watching them set.
To get on down, nobody wants to pay my duty. Nobody wants to hit the can. Oh no, 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 here we go, go. To a place that they don't know, no. Oh no, 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 no. Baby, here we go.
So DMSAT, we are here live in Munich.
Place that they don't know, no. Oh no, 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 no.
Willkommen zum Laureus. Macht's gut.
Tokom filmskog festivala u Cannesu na Chopar partiju.
Willkommen zu Cannes Film Festival.
Welcome to Chopar.
We're the Pussycat Dolls and we love DMSAT.
What is for you personally the more beautiful side of life?
to make my dreams come true.
Fantastic.
Thank you.
Thank you, dear.
Yeah.
Thousand thanks.
Hi, I'm Marina Sheikh, and I love DM Set from Amphor Khans.
I'm Marcus Schenkenberg, I love DM Set.
Hi, I'm Germany's next top model, Lena Gerke, and I love DM Set.
My name is David Kolfar.
Yeah, check it out, man. It's your boy Akon.
Set DM, I love you guys.
From your friend Alicia Keys.
Hello, here's Zach Schulte.
DM Set.
I'm Dan, we are G-Squared, hello from Cannes.
I am Rose McGowan. I give kisses for DM Set.
I give you a huge kiss from Cannes.
Hi there, my name is Cliff Richard. I want to say hello all of you to DM Set.
I am David Coulthard, driver for the Red Bull Formula One team.
My name is Isabel Christens.
Hi, I'm Bonnie Tyler, and you're watching DM Set.
Hello, DM Set.
Hello, I'm Ornella Muti, and welcome to the DM Fair.
Hi, DM Set. I'm Barfelli. I'm here with your part.
Hello, from Cannes. Thank you.
Hey guys, this is Bob St. Clair.
My name is Franz Beckenbauer.
Ove sedmice stavljamo iz Cannes sa Roberto Cavalli Žurke.
The shop opening in Cannes, Roberto Cavalli shop. It's fantastic.
Thank you very much to be here with me.
Hello. Big kiss from Cannes to DM Set. Ciao.
Ciao DM Set, I love you. Enjoy.
I am Renzo Rosse from Diesel.
Ivana, DM Set. Hi.
Hello, I'm Jean-Claude Van Damme, JCBD, on DM Set. Yeah, and soon we'll be talking together.
Nobody wants to pay my duty. Nobody wants to hit the can. Oh no, 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 here we go, go to a place that they don't know, no. Oh no, 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 no. Baby, here we go.
This is Elton John and greetings from Ishgill, okay?
I am Flavio Briatore, on DM Set. Ciao.
Hi, I'm Paris Hilton.
And I'm Nikki Hilton.
You're watching DM Set.
And I'm very pleased to be here with you.
Next to me is Bernie Ecclestone. It's really a great pleasure to meet you. Hello.
And you. And
Tamara Ecclestone, and I love DM Set.
Hello, it's Gea Berger by DM Set.
Veliki pozdrav svim gledalcima sa Laureus Awards, hvala.
Aber es geht um Novak und er ist einfach ein feiner Sportler.
Tausend Dank, danke schön.
Volume DM Set.